Hello, Mykie. Do you want to play a game?
With Jigsaw on October 27th. If you're a longtime zombie, you know I have a kind of unhealthy guilty pleasure sort of obsession with the Saw movies. A particular shot in Saw 3 is actually the reason I changed my college major from psychology to film. True story, I swear. And the original Saw was a hugely influential film that made me fall in love with horror and gory things all at age 14. So I really feel like a big part of what I'm doing today in life is because of Saw. So let me tell you, in my wildest dreams, I never thought I'd one day get to say this, but Jigsaw is partnering with me to bring you this video. I'm going to the red carpet world premiere of the movie. Tobin Bell legitimately recorded that intro for me. And I was asked to be an official Jigsaw nurse for their iconic blood drive campaign. Someone pinch me, I must be dreaming, it's all too cool. Sorry, I'm dorking out. But I can't help it. It's a surreal moment for me, okay? I ran around my apartment and screamed when they asked me to be one of their nurses, which is my way of playing it cool in this scenario. Oh, by the way, a vlog about the Saw nurses will be out soon. Yeah! Anyway, guess what? The lovely babes over at Lionsgate are giving you zombies free tickets to go see Jigsaw while supplies last if you click the link in the description and use code Mykie. Free gore, y'all! Just like what you get here, except the really good movie kind. Fluff, I need to calm down. I'm calm. I'm fine. I'm calm. I'm calm. Let's become everyone's favorite little trach-writing, nightmare-inducing, maniacally giggling puppet, shall we? All right. So, Billy the Puppet is a classic horror icon, and it's no wonder. He's just so darn pretty. We're going to do our best to make ourselves as pretty as him using a two-piece prosthetic. One for the stationary part of the face, and one for the marionette-style jaw. The easiest and most affordable way to do this is to grab liquid latex from your local Halloween store, or order it online. A curved surface about the size of your face to sculpt on top of, in my case, a life cast of my actual face, a reference picture of Billy the Puppet, and cotton balls. You're gonna need a lot. If you're new to this channel, welcome! Here we commonly use cotton and latex to build up custom prosthetic pieces. But if you've been here more times than Saw has sequels, you know how this works. To briefly go over it, liquid latex is like bread, and cotton is like slices of meat and cheese. Now make a sandwich. Latex goes down directly on your curved surface, cotton in the middle, and then more latex on top of that until you can manipulate that concoction into whatever shape you want. It helps to keep your fingers or a metal tool coated in latex so you can move over your working area more easily. Quick note, depending on what surface you're working on, you might want to first grease it up with an oil-based makeup remover prior to the sculpt phase. I'm using isopropyl mirror state here. Anyway, Billy's face is pretty simple. You want to build up an intense brow, giant round cheeks, a big hooked nose, and a lower portion of the face including a chin. As you'll notice here, I don't cover the entire sides of my lower face. I only bring the cotton down on the sides as far as about halfway to the middle of the cheeks. This will give us the right face shape without having to make the overall prosthetic huge. Now the trick to really sell the puppet look will be to make the chin piece separate from the rest of the face. We want the chin to move independently like Billy's actually does in the films. So be sure when you get to the lower portion of the face, there's a clear break between these jowl areas and the chin itself. Build up the chin pretty thick as well so that it's sturdy. The nose was probably the trickiest part because it's big already, but in order to cover over my existing nose and get the right shape, it really had to be big. I ended up building up the cheeks and chin even more after that to weigh the nose out proportionately to the rest of the face. Would you look at that, it's 6:40 in the morning, whoops. When you're happy with the shape of your sculpt, call it a day and let the latex dry thoroughly overnight. The next morning it should look a little something like this. Powder it good and then carefully pick up a side and start peeling it off. You could paint it before peeling it off, but since I was worried about the red bullseye cheeks smudging onto the white, I figured it would be better to do the majority of the handling before the paint was done. Make sure you cut out holes for your eyes and poke holes in the nose area if you don't want to be a mouth breather. When I clear the eye holes, I try to just rip off what I can because blending uneven ripped edges is easier than blunt, clean cut edges. Not always avoidable, but when it is, give it a shot. On to paint, which is super, super simple. I'm using a white water activated paint first and then going over it a second time with a white cream paint to make it more even. I didn't go straight for the cream paint because they smudge so easily that I wanted to keep the cream layer as thin as possible. I did the red swirls on the cheeks with a water-activated paint and a skinny little brush. Finished off the chin piece, and at least for the prep, that's all we need to paint. On to the application. Hi, my face looks extra spooky today. Before you all ask, no, these are actually my natural eyes, but I get that a lot. If you're new here, I lost my eyebrows in an incident with an industrial vacuum cleaner, and I'd rather not relive it, so please don't ask any more questions about it. Thanks. For now, just worry about sitting a bald cap on your head. We want to use a bald cap to push our hairline back like Billy's, and also to get rid of our ears because he does not appear to have any. Poor guy. So using Prozade or spirit gum adhesive, lay that around the areas the bald cap will eventually sit. When you place it down, do your best to avoid wrinkles, though that's tough unless you have the exact right size for your head. Make sure to attach it down the sides of your neck too, but we don't need to worry about blending our edges for the bald cap to our skin since the prosthetic will sit over top of it. Mark where the edges of your prosthetic will sit by painting over the top edge with white paint and inside the eye area with black. Then when you remove it, you'll know exactly where to place the adhesive. Quickly, I decided to use white in a few places near the edges of the prosthetic so I didn't have to worry about getting in those tight spots once the piece is applied. And I look like a deranged knockoff creepypasta character. Place adhesive everywhere inside your main prosthetic except on these little jowl areas that sit next to the chin. Leave that part naked. You also want to put adhesive on your face where the prosthetic will sit. Dance break! If you're using Prozade, it'll turn clear and shiny, like so, when it's tacky and ready. Lay the prosthetic on your face, and I generally like to hold mine in place for a few seconds until I know it's made good contact with the adhesive. So basically, another dance break opportunity. Now, this is why we wanted to keep the gel things detached from our face. Like I said, keeping the main prosthetic isolated and attaching the chin separately will mean only the chin moves when you talk and will be the thing that sells the puppet jaw vibe. But if you glued the jowls onto your face, it would pick up the movement from your jaw and it would break the illusion. So glue the chin piece on, and then we're going to do a little work on our receding hairline. I'm using just latex and my fingers to add an uneven layer pretty far back onto the bald cap, all the way back to where I anticipate attaching the wig later. I'm doing this in globs that slightly overlap the edge of the facial prosthetic so that when this dries, this will help mesh the textures and make it appear more seamless. I had an extremely hard time seeing out of these contacts, hence me not being able to tell I was out of focus for half this tutorial. Sorry about that. So if you're going the same route for the eyes, you may want to get help to blend the prosthetic with the bald cap. Another option is to paint his red and black eyes onto your eyelids. Here I'm just blacking out the sides of the face that my prosthetic didn't cover over to create the illusion of the right face shape, and also painting the neck. I blacked out the sides and painted a skinnier neck just to keep it proportional to the face, but really, you don't see Billy's neck much. So I didn't spend too much time on this knowing I was just going to keep my shoulders shrugged to stay in character anyway. When the latex on the top of your head is dry, you can paint that with whatever white paint you used for the prosthetic. Then I worked a bit on the eyes. I used some more liquid latex to blend the edges of the eye holes to my skin. The latex that I use is very mild on the ammonia stingy scale, so I'm able to do this without any irritation, but most latexes available to you will probably be too difficult to put near your eyes, so you may want to skip this step. I also used black water activated paint to shape the eyes more accurately to his and make them look overall a bit bigger. I waited to paint the mouth on until everything was attached so I didn't risk smearing it and knew everything was aligned properly. But all you need to do for this is take a red paint, draw a line on the upper lip that curves once it passes the width of the chin piece, and then draw a line on for the bottom lip on the chin piece that's just straight across and stops at the edge of that prosthetic. Really simple, but it makes it so creepy, so fast. I also quickly used a bit of gray paint in the split between the main prosthetic and the chin piece to accentuate that break. Billy in the Saw films has a glossy finish, but I chose to go with a matte version since adding a clear gloss coat to the prosthetic would have added a whole extra prep day just for drying and airing out the fumes. If you go with this matte version too, powder away any shininess so that it's all uniform. Stretch. We're almost there. Wig out! I got the wig and the whole costume off Amazon. I'll leave links in the description. Razor blades. Living with Jigsaw? Anyone? Anyone? And that's how you do it, zombies. I hope you learned some stuff. Like some valuable life lessons. Because most people are so ungrateful to be alive. But not you. Not anymore. Because you get to see Jigsaw this week, am I right? Okay, yeah! game over.
Where's my Oscar?
This is my nightmare. I'm literally having heart palpitations right now. I really did. I just had one. Doing it for you guys. You. And your entertainment. So I hope you're happy.
Okay, let's do this.
Razor blades. Razor blades. Razor blades. Razor blades.
This is what 5 pounds of glitter looks like.
How do you intend to get this off?
I don't intend to get it off ever. I understand that this is what my life's gonna be now.